Off they go. Those flying sons of thunder who proudly fly the insignia of our Army Air Forces into every corner of the globe. A dozen fronts feel the impact of their valor as they blaze a trail of victory after victory across enemy skies. Just look at them up there. Proud, confident, flying straight at their targets. The fighting creed of Army Air Force Chief General H.H. Arnold, inspiring them on to greater glory.
Carry out your mission in spite of hell and high water.
Remember how they did it at Bataan and Midway? The Solomons? And over-occupied France? And Tokyo and Germany? But you know, planes can't roar into battle after battle and come through completely unscathed all the time. Damages are inevitable. It might be the wing, or the ailerons or tail that bear the scars of enemy machine guns, or a landing gear disabled in a battle. Here's one coming in now, and just watch the way that pilot's handling her. Nose high, flaps down. He's going to try for an emergency pancake landing. Here he comes, lower and lower, and there she is, as pretty a forced landing as you've ever seen. Let's see what's wrong with her. Say, just look at those props. Emergency repairs must be made. Made well and made fast. Those planes have got to get back into the sky. And to the ground crew of the Army Air Forces falls this tremendous task. In their capable hands, those tools and the skill and speed with which they use them, they hold the balance between victory and defeat. For these men, whose job it is to repair and rebuild our fighter planes, have given America one of her greatest formulas for victory. By restoring our damaged planes to maximum efficiency and getting them back into battle in time, they have doubled the striking power of America's air arm. Who are the men who have so quietly assumed this terrific responsibility? These mechanical miracle makers. You know them, that is, you knew them in civilian life. The automobile mechanic, the electrician and the fellow who serviced your refrigerator, the locksmith, radio repairman, airplane mechanic, farm mechanic, bicycle repairman, bench assembler, instrument maker or repairman, maintenance mechanic, sheet metal worker, or any one of 100 trades that require some mechanical ability. And say, if any of you fellas out there would like to get into the Army Air Force ground crew, if you're between 18 and 50 and a qualified aircraft mechanic or radio operator, and you're not in defense work, or even if you are holding down a defense job but face induction in the Army soon, well, brother, better hop down to your nearest enlistment office and join up with one of the greatest outfits in the service. Want to see how these boys operate? The part they play in winning the war for us? Well, let's go out to one of our far-flung air bases and talk to one of the men, Sergeant Joe Allison. He looks like he's just about finished with a pretty tough job. Must have a minute to spare. Say, Joe.
Huh?
How'd you happen to get into this outfit?
Well, I used to be a mechanic at French's Garage in New Rochelle. I knew the Army would be wanting me soon, so I figured I'd better sign up with something I liked, knew how to do.
And how's it going?
Oh, swell. You see, I started out as a private, and in less than 3 months, they made me a sergeant. All the guys around here move up pretty fast.
Seems to be a lot of activity going on, Joe. What's happening?
Oh, plenty. Got 5 cripples in last night. That's what we call the ships that are scratched up a bit after a fight. Our orders were to get them fixed up by 11 o'clock this morning. Really an impossible job.
Impossible, huh? Well, what are you going to do?
What do you think? We'll get them ready, all right. Jack Foster over there is just finishing up a wing assembly job. And Bill Martin, he's got a little more work in the ring cowling. And Chuck Silver's just about through repairing the motor. Oh, yes, and Freddie Quinn. He had quite a job in that bomber, the Pancake. He's just about finished. Steve Hicks hasn't got much more to go in straightening out that landing wheel. We'll get them ready, all right.
Yes, they were ready, all right. Joe Allison did a terrific job on that prop you saw smashed while doing a pancake landing. Yes, sir, that plane went back upstairs and knocked 4 enemy pursuit ships out of the sky. See that squadron taking off for battle? Those 4 planes are a part of it, and they're not cripples anymore. They're just as good as new and raring for action again. And believe us, that makes a difference when you start counting sides. And that ring cowling job that Bill Martin was working on. That one scored a direct hit on a loaded Jap transport. And that burned-out motor that Chuck Silver was overhauling, it sure runs smooth now. Smooth enough to catch a wolf pack of submerging Jap subs and sink same. Yes, and that's just the way it's been going wherever our air combat crews are based. Ask any pilot, he'll tell you that many of our greatest air battles are won right down there on the ground. To the men of the Army Air Force ground crew and to the civilian mechanics who will one day be contributing their skill to American air victories, Uncle Sam and the officers and men of the United States Army salute you.
Oh, by the way, here's the lowdown for any of you fellas between 18 and 50 who have had any mechanical experience. Why not get into the branch of the service that you're best suited for? Right now, you can get in on the ground floor of the ground crew of the Air Forces. Go down today and apply at your nearest Army recruiting office. There's a swell spot in one of the greatest outfits in the Army Air Forces awaiting you. You'll be serving your country better by doing the kind of work you know how to do best. Yes, this is your chance to keep them flying, so that we can keep that grand old flag flying.